artist, next minister coming up. Kasha, the poet, where you at?
Make some noise.
Yeah.
Jesus right beside me, guide me, making my crooked way straight. He's my life jacket and he's my lifeguard, just in case he got to revive me from drowning in my sinful ways. I'm walking beside the still waters with Jesus, and there ain't no waves, just smooth sailing for days and days and days. Before he picked me up, I was blind from the night, but he cleaned me up and turned my darkness into light, so I can see clearly now. My only question is, what took you so long to come? You'd be surprised at what type of lifestyle he brought me from. Yeah, I'm walking beside the still waters, towards the border, when time comes to a stop, where there is no more use for a clock, where there is never-ending, everlasting, continuously endless, infinite love-making the heavens above between him and me. Oh, how I thank you, Jesus, for setting my soul free. Now I see that without you in my life, I am nothing. But you washed away my sins with your bloodshed and made me into something. It's for that I love you and I adore you and I accept you as Lord and Savior of my life, my mind, body, and soul. I give to you for you to do as you like. And thank you for saving me from my dry desert land. And thank you for pulling my blood and my deadly sins that tried to suck me in like quicksand. And thank you for showing me who you made me to be. Thank you for giving me purpose and the privilege to walk beside the still waters like Psalm 20. Yeah. I was walking down my block the other day. I bumped into this guy. He was flying. He was looking my way. He said, "How are you, my dear? I got a lot of shit. And this ain't no freestyle. This is gonna cost you. Not no nickels and dimes, but your life getting put back in order." He said, "Can I give you the keys to the kingdom?" I was like, "Who are you anyway?" I thought he was tripping. He said, "My name is Jesus, and no one is to mention that I can give you life more abundantly." I was like, "Is that a question? How could that be? Or what?" He said, "With my salvation, love, power, and peace overshadowing me. This you must be in peace." He said, "You don't know me, but I know you very well." After that, I was about to turn on his bed. He said, "Don't leave now, I got more to show you." He grabbed my hand, and I was through. This peace that I never felt went straight through my body. Then he pleasantly said to me, "I want to put your life back in order. And on top of that, I'll give you peace beyond understanding and the reward." I was thinking, "What is this you trying to tell me?" So I said, "I need you to tell me, who do you work for?" He smiled and said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. Like I said, my name is Jesus, but you can call me the Rock of Christ. I was sent from above because of love for the redemption of all mankind. I was crucified, my dear. You see the nails scarred for love, and I had you on my mind. I want to give you something that you really need, indeed. By now, I know this was no sales tactic. This guy in Jesus was a real one. Oh, I gotta have him. My grandmother used to tell me about this guy, and I studied it. By the way things was looking, well, I never lied. That was called the media. Even last, know that you did.
Yeah! 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 Chill. How long you been doing what you do, man?
6 years.
Okay, now you got something coming up pretty soon you want to tell the folks about?
Yes. It's my first CD release. It's going to be Sunday, September the 6th, down at the Belvedere Hotel in Baltimore, Maryland. If you're interested in attending, I have flyers for you, and I do have tickets also. The ticket is $20, and it includes a copy of the CD, a meal, and admission. Can't beat that.
Okay. Right. Give it up one time for Pastor Poet.